Jailed Queensland health fraudster Joel Barlow says his $16 million scam could have been exposed by a simple company search. State political editor Cathy Border is at State Parliament and she joins us now. And Cathy, a damning CMC report has revealed a speeding ticket 6 years ago should have blown Barlow's cover.
That's right, Georgie. For the first time, we see what Barlow told the CMC, and the speeding ticket was just one of many instances that authorities should have picked up on, but it got lost in a bureaucratic maze. Police, the CMC, the health department, they all missed it. Colleagues complained about him from the very beginning. He'd turn up late to work. At lunchtime, he'd leave for hours and not come back. He bullied junior staff, making them cry. And when things started to heat up on him, he'd simply take leave, even telling one manager he had a serious illness. The biggest irony of all in this is that one of his managers told the CMC that Joel Barlow wasn't very good with budgeting. Even Joel Barlow couldn't believe his luck. The Queensland Health Finance Officer turned fraudster, telling CMC investigators,
"A simple ABN search would have stopped this in the beginning. It was a gamble."
His path of partying and opulent living began in October 2007. He registered a phony business, The Muse, and the next day started siphoning money, just over $2,000. Within months, he'd swiped more than $11,000. In total, over 4 years, Joel Barlow netted $16.69 million, but he didn't know how much he'd taken.
"I didn't. If I ran out of money, I'd submit another invoice."
It does seem extraordinary that this fraudulent activity was not identified earlier.
Previously, it was laissez-faire. It was walk in and walk out with millions of dollars.
The CMC report exposing an embarrassing litany of red flags that should have exposed the fraudster. He constantly exceeded limits on a generous corporate credit card. Some bosses believing the fake prints, giving him exceptional treatment,
including time off in the mornings to write royal correspondence.
2 months before the fraud started, he failed to return a departmental car on time. The corruption watchdog was told, but an ethics officer declared no fraud risk. Barlow was reprimanded more than 3 years later. Most telling of all, an anonymous CMC complaint alleging Barlow's fraud was dismissed.
There has been managerial guidance delivered to that officer.
"I'm extremely frustrated that it has taken so long for the CMC to conclude this matter."
What the government is now proposing is to take the CMC backwards, where there would be no anonymous complaints whatsoever.
The prince, now a prisoner. Now, the CMC makes the point that if the government does outsource more services, that there'll be an even greater need to check on how public money is being spent. It also recommended action against 8 Queensland health officers, but the minister makes the point he's already sacked one of them and acted on the others, and he notes that the CMC started investigating this 2 years ago.
Thank you. Cathy Border, live there at State Parliament.